Welcome to the Media Bubble Podcast, the podcast that talks about movies, anime, comics, video games, and whatever we feel like. I'm your host, Fredrik, and with me as always is my co-host, Karol. And in today's episode, we are going to talk about chocolate bars.
Yes.
To be precise, we have a bit of a tournament arc, per se. We have 16 different chocolates, which we are going to have to face each other to determine what the best chocolate bar kind of thing is.
Yes, and I think most of them are like readily available to us. So if your fave is not in the bracket, give us a text, or not a text.
Give us a comment down below.
Yes, and maybe we'll investigate your candy at a later date.
Yeah, that's something to say is that the some of these chocolate bars are very specific to our country that we live in.
Exactly. We have Swebars, so we already doxed ourselves.
Yes. We also have a brand mark called Marabou, which I'm 90% sure that that's Swedish, right?
Yeah, I haven't seen it anywhere else.
So we are having some, there are some chocolate bars which are widely known as Mars, Twix, Snickers, things like that. And yes, in the first round we are going to explain each chocolate bar a little bit deeper than maybe we do in the second round and things like that. Just to give a bit of a presentation.
Exactly. There is no point of talking about the same thing again. Also, just a preface, when we compiled the list of all of the candy, you put it in a randomly generated order.
Yes.
So some of the choices can be tough.
Yeah.
And also, we have not picked some of the candy on the list, like lions, like lion, for example, because it's just not really common here.
No, we're not. There are probably some chocolates that we could have taken, but I don't know. I feel pretty good about our list either way.
Yeah, so let's go.
No, it's a list comprised of things that you can usually find here, and some of our favorites.
Okay, so with the first choice is...
The first round. Yes, do you want to present this, Karol?
Yeah, Milky Way versus the Barbell Salty Peanut White Protein Bar.
So, we have something that I can say pretty quickly. Yes, for the most part, I've eaten most of these chocolate bars. Salty peanuts, I never tasted, so can you explain to me how that tastes?
I am holding myself back from making a really good joke. Milky Way, you've heard about it, you tasted it, it's pretty great. We even have some of the candy before we started recording.
Yeah, it was pretty good.
Yeah, so it's just, I like Milky Way because it's just like this fluffy, chocolatey fluff covered in a thin coat of chocolate.
That was a pretty good description.
That's how I feel about it. And it's just a delight to eat because it doesn't get stuck in your teeth. And even before we were recording, like, I was supposed to focus on the taste and I've already eaten it.
Yeah, you ate it all when you were going to try to taste the taste.
Versus Barbell Salty Peanut. So this is more comparable to Lion. It's crunchy, it has a coat of white chocolate with some salty peanut caramel bits inside. It's also with protein, so you can feel, you can like feel a little bit better about yourself when you eat it, that, oh, it's not only candy, it's also protein.
Okay. I'm not sure if we already are making a decision, but for me this choice is kind of easy.
Because
even though I haven't eaten salty peanuts, I will admit Milky Way is one of my favorite chocolate bars.
It is.
It's really good.
It's really good. And like, even though like I'm not dissing salty peanut because it's like one of my favorite tastes, but yeah, Milky Way win this one.
Yeah, I think that was a pretty easy win for us.
Yeah.
So, to the next round, I guess. We have Bounty versus Yep, which here comes this Swedish country thing. Yep is a candy which I think only exists in Sweden.
I haven't seen it anywhere else.
It's from Marabou, which is that Swedish company that we discussed before.
Yes, and Marabou is pretty big. They go, they have assortments from like everything. They have chocolates in boxes.
You're going to see more of Marabou on this list.
Yeah, they have thin wafers with like seasonings. They have candy bars. They have like pretty much. Like, if it has chocolate, Marabou has it.
Yes, and Yep is actually one of the few candies that we ate before recording.
And it was bad.
I didn't remember it as one of the best, like... When you are in the shop and you're supposed to choose a candy, I have a hard time feeling that you will choose...
I would never choose Yep over anything else.
Yeah.
Like for listeners, Yap is it's similar to Milky Way. It's also a caramelly, chocolatey fluff, but not as light. It also has like a coat of caramel inside, and then it's coated in chocolate. So it's like a little bit more chewy Milky Way, but the quality of the chocolate, from what I felt like, was a little worse.
Yeah, it's not one of my favorites. On the other hand, we have Bounty, which I actually really like. It has this cocoa flavor.
Yeah, it's my to-go sweet, actually.
Is that your to-go sweet?
Yes. If I can find it in the store and I'm feeling like kind of peckish, I'll probably pick it up. I really like coconut.
Mm, I really like Bounty too, so this round feels kind of easy for us. It's Bounty.
We're blazing through.
Yeah, this is going quicker than I thought, but at the same time, we're 7 minutes into the episode, so...
just a quick disclosure, Bounty is also like a candy bar. It's coconut pieces
I think everything has sugar in chocolate, but it's coconut and chocolate in one beautiful mixture.
A beautiful marriage of flavor.
And here, next round, we have two very Swedish chocolates, actually. We have... is Kexchocklad Swedish?
I don't think it's only Swedish. No, like, if you go to Denmark, you can probably find it.
Yeah, you probably can, actually. I take that back. But we have Marabou Schweizernut versus Kexchocklad.
Yes, so would you like to describe Kex?
How do you describe that? It's kind of like a mixture between... It's mostly like a...
It's like a thin... It's like a thin
biscuit,
wafer with...
Biscuit or...
Yeah, it's like thin, biscuity wafer with chocolate layers in between.
Yeah, tiny chocolate layer between biscuits. It has a pretty alright taste I'm going to be honest. I have tasted some... Things that are similar when you explained it, but I gotta say that cake chocolate is probably my favorite in that combination.
I agree, because I think Kex, like the premise is really basic, and you can probably find a lot of competitors that have like the similar candy. It's just chocolatey wafers, just biscuit wafers interchanged with chocolate, but the quality of the chocolate is really good. And it's just big enough that you want another bite.
And it's a chocolate that you can eat a lot of, because it doesn't really get as tiring as some other chocolate might get.
Exactly, it's really light, and they sometimes have really fun flavors. I think I found what is it? Cinnamon flavored? Cannelbulla flavored? They must, but
maybe. And they do have a lot of different taste when it comes to chocolate. There was newly done one vegan white cake chocolate. But was it dark chocolate or white chocolate?
Either way, I'm up for trying it.
Yeah, that's not on our list, unfortunately. But it, Kexchocklad is it sounds so Swedish when we say Kexchocklad.
Yeah, they have a lot of ads. Like let's say merchandising probably has a lot of influence of what we find like appealing in this list.
Mm. And then we have Marabou Swedish nut, which for me, I'm going to be honest with one thing. I don't like nuts. Don't think any dirty there.
Not even these nuts? Not even Schweizer nuts?
No, not even these nuts. No, I just don't like peanuts. We can say peanuts, right?
I don't really.
Yeah, I don't really like peanuts that much, to be honest. I can't really eat it, to be honest.
Really?
No, not really. I don't like peanuts at all.
I love peanuts. actually like chocolate with nuts and like raisins is one of my favorite flavors.
Yeah, you gave me once upon a time a chocolate which has both peanuts and
raisins. It's just so good. It's like a trail mix but in chocolate.
Yeah, the problem with that chocolate is that I like raisins even less. but I remember me taking a bite of that chocolate and then needed to go and water my mouth.
You haven't told me about that.
You were there.
I must have been so long time ago.
It was a long time ago, to be fair, but you were there.
Okay, so I think Kex.
Is it cakes for you, even if you like these nuts?
Yes.
It's cakes for me, too.
Like, I'm thinking, if I went to the store and had to pick, probably cakes.
Okay, then, next matchup, we have Plopp versus Mars.
Mars. So what is Plopp?
Yeah, Plopp is, it's apparently the same as market as Kexchocklad when I look at it.
Cloetta.
And it's kind of this how do I describe it? It has this
caramel
filling into it, and it's
gooey.
Yeah. It kind of takes over the whole thing if you're going to be honest. Like it's a lot of filling in these small bites.
Yeah. And I agree, like the chocolate, the same with Kex in it, it's a good quality. It's just that
it almost doesn't feel like chocolate, to be honest.
Yeah. It has this feeling like it's just maybe like just a sweet. But I think maybe the caramel inside is not as good as the other candies. It feels more sugary.
Think, yeah, it kind of does. We have some here actually, so should we take another bite?
Oh god.
I remember eating something very similar a lot when I was a kid, but I don't like it as much anymore. It's too, what can you say, sugary or?
It's really sweet.
Yeah, it's too sweet.
Mm. Nom nom nom.
Yeah, we're eating chocolate in a live podcast.
This is like one of the major rules of podcasting. Do not eat.
what can you do?
And versus that we have Mars.
Which is one of my favorite chocolate bars, to be honest. Which I feel like I have said that sometimes already, but this time I really mean it. Mars is one of my favorite. And I feel like it's a good mixture between the taste of chocolate and this, I guess, caramel feeling
we
talked about.
Now that I think about it, Yap is like a lesser Yap is like a lesser Mars.
Yeah, you know, some way I guess this was a really good matchup in some way, but I feel like Mars blend it so much better than Plopp ever did.
Yeah, I agree. Like, it's just like, also, I just,
I feel like it's more chocolate in Mars too.
Yeah, I agree.
So this match up
Mars,
definitely Mars. So to the next round, which are between two Marabou chocolate bars, which we have this time milk chocolate and milk chocolate with dime.
Now that I think about it, we should have just picked a dime instead of chocolate with dime.
Yeah, you're probably right about that one. Should we maybe do that?
We might have to change it in post.
Yeah, I'm going to change the one of the pictures in post. Here we're doing milk chocolate versus pure dime.
Yeah.
And if you think about every chocolate on this list, I would say milk chocolate is Marabou's milk chocolate is for me the most pure chocolate you can find.
It's really good. I have to agree. It just tastes like sublime.
Yeah, when you think of chocolate for me, that is Marabou's milk chocolate.
Yeah, and I've tasted British and Polish and German and like Norwegian chocolate, and I still think Marabou is one of the best ones.
I don't know, it just feels like that's the most, I've said this before, but it's for me the most pure chocolate there is. And maybe because it's the most pure chocolate is because one thing with Marabou's milk chocolate is
they do a lot of flavors.
Yeah, they do a lot of flavors of this specific brand.
Exactly.
Like you could see before with the
Nelly one.
Yeah.
Yeah. So yeah, they do a lot of different flavors. Like there were sugar, like sea salt, polka gris, lemon.
Which
chili.
I kind of feel just proves the more the point that this is really the most pure chocolate in some way.
Yeah.
And we have dime, which I'm going to be honest about, I'm not that into dime.
I'm not into dime myself, but I do know people that are into it.
Okay.
So my cousins,
yeah.
They don't have access to Swedish sweets, so each time they come here, they buy a lot of dime. Because it's just like, what dime is it's like a thin coat of caramel that's been crystallized, so it's hard, and it's coated like lightly in chocolate. So when you chew on it, like you can snap it in your mouth, and you get this crunchy, chocolatey mix, which is good, because it's not like hard, it's just good.
I think that description you just did there is the reason why I don't like it very much, to be honest.
Really?
I don't really like this. I'm not really sure what it is about dime, to be honest, but I don't really like the
snap.
More when I take a bite of it, it kind of feels like, how am I supposed to say? I don't like the flavors that comes out in this. Yeah.
Maybe it's the because like when the caramel is like a little bit gooey and still
it's
and
a bit
liquidish.
More, it's a bit harder chocolate, if you can say it like that.
So you just don't like the feeling when it's really hard, like it's snappy and.
No, I don't like the hardness. I don't think have a lot to do with it. I just don't like the taste, to be honest, and I have a hard time describing why I don't like the taste. But I just don't kind of like it. I remember when I was a kid, it was popular to have two different ice cream flavors.
Mm-hmm.
It was one with just pure ice cream, and then there was one with ice cream that had dime in it, which was
those little balls, yeah, those chocolatey little balls with caramel.
Yeah,
I know.
I didn't like that, and I for some reason I kind of feel like the. That has always stayed in my memory, maybe when I eat the dime.
So you have a tragic backstory with dime?
Yeah, my tragic backstory. No, it's not tragic. It's just that I never really liked it.
But you know what? In this matchup, I'd agree that dime is the lesser one. Like, pure Marabou chocolate is better.
What do you feel about dime?
It's okay. Like, as I said, I know people that enjoy thyme, and like as I said, like I have a friend in England who also enjoys thyme, but I don't know, it just gets stuck in my teeth.
So I guess this goes to milk chocolate then. Next we have Marabou Appleseed Croquant versus Twix.
Twix, like. I think we explained enough about Marabou, and our viewers probably, or listeners are already aware of what Twix is.
Twix is kind of the most well-known out of all these chocolate. No, maybe Snickers is probably more well-known, but Twix is kind of big also.
Yeah. Also, just like a little tidbit to know, in Sweden, it's really like popular with brand name chocolate, like Bounty, Milky Way, Mars, Snickers, Lion. While, like, for example, where I originally come from, a lot of the times you can find in store, sure, you can find the big brand names, but it's more popular with, like, locally produced candy bars. So, like, Princessa, Prince Polo, Grzeszki.
I gotta say that when I was little, then there were so many other different brands of chocolate, which I remember that doesn't exist anymore.
Is that true?
Yeah, there were some other chocolates. I have a hard time to describe them right here and now, but there were more Swedish style kind of chocolates here too. But I guess
the big brands took over.
I guess in some way. To describe Appleseed Croquant little, it's that they have taken an orange, that is Appleseed, right?
Yeah.
Oh, they have taken an orange in the chocolate, and to be honest, I'm not really sure if this one is really that popular, but I took it in this list just because I like it very much.
Isn't Appleseed Croquant, is it just like caramelized orange skin, like it's
kind of
because it's sweet and it's like has this little citrusy flavor which goes well with the chocolate, but I don't think it alone can compete with Twix.
No, to me Twix wins this one kind of easy, and let's just say Twix wins this one and move on.
Twix wins.
So I'm kind of happy with the results now, but
it's gonna get tougher on when we have to pick the winners.
Yeah, that's when it's going to get really tough. But for now, we have Snickers versus Swebar,
and
which I have tasted Snickers, but as I described before, I'm not really that big fan of peanuts.
Yeah.
So I'm not really that big fan of Snickers. Which is Snickers the biggest brand of chocolate? Because I feel like the commercials for Snickers are much more than
you don't
any
see,
other.
You don't see any commercials for, but you don't see commercials for Mars, Bounty, Milky Way, or the other ones we picked out.
No.
But like we see commercials for Twix.
Yeah, those are. I see a lot of commercials for Twix. There was one time there, I remember like they had this chocolate when, or commercial when. When you're hungry, eat a Twix or something. You're not yourself.
Eat a Snickers, not a Twix.
Yeah. I like Twix more. Yeah, but when you're hungry, eat a Snick. When you're not you, when you're hungry.
Yeah, I mean, like we said, like advertising probably has a lot of influenced us about these candy. Like in comparison to Swebar, which I don't think anyone knows outside of Sweden. Like, Snickers has a big
presence.
I gotta
be honest, I don't even really know Swebar, to be honest. This is one of the few I haven't tasted before.
Okay, so I found who produces Snickers. It's Mars Incorporated.
Mars Incorporated.
Yeah, so it's the same company who makes Bounty, Mars, M&M's, Milky Way.
Do they do Twix too?
And Twix!
Yeah, I had a feeling about that one. But anyway...
They also make pet food, which Pedigree.
Well, that's reaffirming. Anyway, can you describe Swebar a little bit for me? Because I can be honest, I haven't really tasted it. Yes. I noticed that there were multiple flavors at least.
Yes, so it has a lot of similarities with barbells. So whilst barbells is like this premium protein bar, nutty flavored, Swebar is a little bit more affordable, a little bit more chill. It doesn't have enough the same advertising as the previous one, but I think the taste is good. It's like Bounty, but a little bit less sweet with protein, and it fills you up.
Okay.
So like eating one Swebar, probably like if you're hungry, you eat one of those, and you can like hold out for dinner or afternoon tea.
Okay. What do you feel about Snickers?
As I said, I like peanuts, but I mean, in comparison to these two, I'd probably go for a Swebar.
Okay, because to be honest, you get to choose here, because I haven't eaten Swebars and I don't like Snickers, so it's your choice here.
I'll go with Swebar.
And that's probably the most...
the dark horse of the race.
That's probably the one pick that was probably the most surprising of them all. So far, we have just taken out the biggest brand of the whole tournament in the first round.
Hey, maybe it's overhyped.
And what we have left is Toblerone, Swedish Miss Milk Chocolate with honey and almond nougat.
And Milka.
Yeah, Milka is kind of like Milk Chocolate in some way. It's an other country's brand.
It's German.
German.
Yes.
It's kind of German is me. Milk chocolate.
Exactly. And Toblerone, it's Swiss, just as the name says. And
I can say this first. I like Marabou's milk chocolate a lot more than Milka. What were you going to say about Toblerone?
No, there was a meme. There was this meme that you don't deserve the big Toblerone.
Okay. How well known is Toblerone?
It's known worldwide, just like Milka. These are big brands we're talking about.
Is Milka a really big brand?
It is. Like, maybe not in Sweden, but Poland, Germany, like, all of Europe knows about Milka.
Yeah, I have tasted Milka before, I can be honest about that one.
It's not as good as Marabou.
Yeah, Marabou. That's kind of the thing. It's kind of hard for me to like it when there's one that's so similar but better.
Shots fired.
I'm just kind of saying what I feel here.
Okay, I mean, I choose Toblerone.
Yeah, you gotta be honest what you feel, right?
Exactly. These are my feelings I'm putting out.
Yeah, I think I like Toblerone better in this matchup. So... we're done with the first round in that case.
Any unexpected results? I think Swebar, but I mean, I'm the one who chose it.
Yeah, that's probably the most unpredictable one, but to be honest, the other choices went how I figured they would go. You're not 100% sure, because I never know really about how your taste is, but... for me, these results are kind of good, to be honest.
Yeah, I agree. So let's go quickly over the round two.
The matchups are...
yeah.
Yeah, in the first matchup we have Milky Way versus Bounty. Second matchup we have Kexchocklad versus Mars. Third matchup is the Marabou Milk Chocolate versus Twix. And fourth matchup is Swebar versus Toblerone, which is surprising that one of those are going to go to semifinal, to be honest.
We might have to go to the store and get some Swebars after that. yes.
Let's see. Milky Way versus Bounty.
Oh, you go first. It's like my two favorite sweets.
Is this your two favorites?
Yeah.
Oh, that makes it kind of hard.
Like,
to be honest, I kind of lean more to Bounty, to be honest, because that one is more unique for me. And Milky Way is really good pure chocolate.
It is.
But there's Bounty is more unique to me in this list than pretty much anything else.
I agree. I mean, we did include Swebar coconut flavored, but But I think, like, in overall, it's probably, like, I have to agree, I find myself more willing to pick up Bounty instead of Milky Way, because Bounty isn't as sweet. Sure, it's still sweet, but you can, like, chew it a little bit more, and the taste of chocolate is not as overpowering. There's, like, more coconut in it.
Yeah. Do you want to go Bounty?
Yeah, Bounty.
Okay, then we're taking Bounty to the semifinals. Goodbye, Milky Way.
Goodbye. Goodbye.
Next matchup, Kexchocklad versus Mars, which for me, do you want to go first?
I mean,
first?
I know what you're gonna say, but I wanted to say Kex.
You want to say Kex? I want to say Mars.
Okay, give me an argument. I'll present you an argument and you can... Let's present an argument for each case.
Okay, I guess you can begin then.
Okay, I think Kex is better because it's light, it has thin wafers, and the chocolate is good.
Yeah, but it doesn't have a lot of chocolate in this, and we're talking about the list of chocolate, and Mars have more chocolate in it, and it also has this nice flavor with caramel in it. That doesn't take over it, but blends in this magical way. Which I feel just tastes amazing.
I also have to agree, actually, because Kex, like, okay, Kex is really good, but it's only like, it's nothing special. It's like the standard. It's like, sure, it's like vanilla ice cream. It's a really good vanilla ice cream, but it's vanilla ice cream.
Apparently, I'm pretty good at this argumenting. More chocolate then. Okay, let's see. Next matchup is the pure chocolate, milk chocolate, versus Twix. I can go either way here, but I want more Twix, to be honest.
Me too.
Should we just take Twix then?
Yeah, I mean, we're united.
We're united here.
Like, I think Twix just has more... I like that it has this biscuit underneath, which is just, yeah, like more... crunchy.
You talked about before the chocolate that you can maybe eat the most of. For me, that is Twix, to be honest. I can. That's the one that I have the easiest time of eating most of.
Yeah, I think the shape and like the small shape of the stick really makes it easy, because I have the same sensation when eating like salty sticks. Because they're just so small.
Yeah. Next matchup, we have Swebar versus Toblerone. Which is an interesting quarterfinal, I have to say.
Okay, so, I mean, let's... I'd still go for Swebar.
Do you like Swebar
Yes, but let's pick Toblerone, because I cannot pick the whole bracket by myself. Like, you don't have experience with Swebar, so it feels...
Yeah, but to be honest, I have pretty much gotten my three choices to see me final, so if you want to go with Swebar, you can go with Swebar.
I'd go with Swebar.
Okay, Swebar to the semi-final.
Let's go, boys, let's go!
The underdog continues. The underdog story.
Okay, now we're going to almost finals.
Okay, we're going to the semi-finals, with other words. Where we find Bounty versus Mars.
I mean, I know you had a good argument last time, but Bounty is just better. I love the coconut flavor, and the chocolate is not overpowering, and it just comes, like...
One quick thing, is Bounty your favorite chocolate?
It is.
It's kind of an interesting matchup in that case, because Mars is my favorite chocolate bar. So this is just pure war love against each other here. What I can give Mars is that when I'm in the right mood of eating it, and I feel you're in this mode where it just tastes amazing to me. But I will admit one thing: it's also the chocolate which I can't eat all the time. Sometimes I just don't feel like I can eat a chocolate a Mars bar, but I at the same time, when I'm in the right mood for it, it's the most amazing taste for me.
But I mean, for me, I feel like I can eat Bounty at any time, because it's not overpowering sweet. But on the other hand, I can eat it almost all the time, but it's a little bit more filling than Mars, so I can't eat a lot of it.
Yeah. The thing is here is that Mars is my favorite chocolate bar, but I really also like Bounty. So I can go with Bounty here, actually.
Do we go with Bounty? I mean, you can Mars can still be your favorite chocolate. This isn't like... Listeners, this isn't a definitive... Like, no. This is the best chocolate, we agree on it. Like, no, it's just brackets.
It's the Media Bubble Podcast, the kings of the chocolate pod, I guess. We're kind of mostly doing this for fun more than anything.
This fight for the money, Bounty goes in for the kill!
But the thing for me with Mars, now when I reveal it is my favorite, it's kind of this thing where when I'm in the right feeling and mood, it tastes absolutely amazing, but it doesn't taste that all the way for me.
How do you mean? Just like at the end you're feeling like this feeling has stopped?
Sometimes when I eat a Mars chocolate bar, when I'm not in the mood for it, then I can feel a little bit tired of it when I come to the end of it. So it's a weird thing, but it really is a mood chocolate for me. Which is not the same about Twix, that I can eat all the time.
Yeah, and now we come to the battle between Twix and Swebars, and Twix has to win.
Yeah, to me this like is
it's,
Twix.
It's an obvious answer. It has the biscuit, it has the chocolate, it has the caramel, it has a thin cover of like goodness.
Yeah, Swebar, it was amazing that you came this far. A little bit of an clap for you there. You made it for farther than probably anyone
than anybody expected.
You made two upsets. That's pretty good.
Exactly. You took out Snickers and Toblerone.
And now we're in the final of Bounty versus Twix, which this is. I feel like this is a bit hard because I feel like Bounty is your favorite, but Twix right here.
Twix is really good.
Twix is my favorite of these two. If I said that Mars was my favorite, then Twix is my second favorite.
But you know what? Even though it's my favorite, and I think Twix deserves to win.
Yeah, I feel like that too, because as I said, we have said that Bounty is unique, but it's not the one that tastes most like chocolate, to be honest.
Exactly. But, I mean, I think for Twix, it's just a combination, like, with Bounty, you get two flavors. Coconut, maybe sugar, and chocolate. Yeah. With Twix, you get, like, a whole experience.
I just feel like you can also eat Twix pretty much all the time.
It's
not a thing that they got is tiring. Yeah, you can share two. It comes in a package with two, if you have a friend. So, I think we both can say that the 2021 Media Bubble Podcast Chocolate Bar winner is. Because we're not going to do this a yearly thing. But the chocolate bar winner for Media Bubble Podcast is Twix.
Twix, congratulations, Twix. You earned it, honey.
You did it.
You
beat
it.
All the other 15 choices.
A lot from the same company.
Are they, actually?
I mean, as I said, Milky Way, Bounty, Mars. I mean, yeah, that was free. And Snickers is from Mars Inc.
Is there something that surprised you in this list, or when you just look at this whole picture?
I was surprised that... I mean, as we said, Sveba, that comes up, but it's because of me, so I can't really be surprised.
Yeah, it's kind of also the thing for me. The Swebar made it kind of far because the chocolates that were against it, I don't care that much for. Snickers, I don't like. Toblerone is a fine chocolate, but I'm not sure.
Not
really
our first
sure
choice.
About. Yeah, it's not really a thing that I think about them a lot.
But I think some of the combinations were nice, like Barbos and Milky Way, just exactly like the matchup between Kex and Mars. Like, that was interesting. Mars and Bounty. Like, I think, like, at the end, we got a little, not heated, but it just, like, got
I gotta say that the randomizing of this list went pretty good, actually.
Yeah.
I felt like
it was interesting. It was interesting throughout. We didn't have, like, a clear winner. Oh, this candy bar is gonna bulldoze everyone else.
Oh, I'm pretty happy with the winner, actually, also.
Yeah, I agree. So we can go and share a Twix.
And now we're going to go out and eat a Twix.
Exactly. Thank you for listening.
Thank you for listening to this chocolate special of Media Bubble Podcast. Don't forget to subscribe and...
like, follow, hit that bell button.
All the things you can do on that specific website you're on.
Exactly. We appreciate if you do. It means a lot.
Yeah. Goodbye.
Goodbye.